Welcome to another guide for going medieval, my fellow gamers. My name is Peter, and in this video, I will show you three different ways to have more villagers, settlers in your game. You will see how random in-game events bring in opportunities to gain new villagers, how to set up a new custom scenario in the game so you start with extra villagers, and how you can use a mod to add as many villagers as you want into your game. For more guides and how-to videos about this amazing game, follow the link up here or in the description. So, first up, the regular way through in-game random events. As you play the game and days go past, you will soon see your first pop-up of a random event, which will give you the opportunity to gain your first new villager. Usually, this is during your first spring, and it's about a villager who escaped from prison. By accepting him into your village, you are inviting a reprisal attack from the local bandits. These villagers often come with a wound or even several wounds, so make sure you have healing supplies on hand to help them out or risk losing a newly gained villager. On one hand, you need more villagers to prepare for winter faster, but on the other hand, if you do not like his stats and skills, you can turn him away and wait for another event. This will give your villagers a negative mood modifier. But what makes it sufferable is the fact that the fewer villagers you have, the more often will you get these random events. So if you want to be picky about new villager stats, it's better to do it now rather than later. As the more villagers you have, the rarer will these random events be. The exact drop-off rate and number of villagers is not known, but most players have noticed a substantial reduction in new villagers after 10 and especially after 14 villagers. That is the soft cap, while the hard cap is more about your hardware and performance. The only thing that you can do to help speed up new villagers' random events is to keep playing, building and developing your village, as by doing so you increase your regional influence. You can see it by going on to the regional menu option. But do note, this is a double-edged sword. Your high influence also makes your village a bigger target for raiders and bandits and makes combat situations more likely. Alright, now I will show you a different way which requires starting a totally new game. When you select your game mode, on the left side of the starting condition screen, you will find an option named Add New. Here you can create your own custom scenario and start. Type in the name, description and narrative, and then choose the starting season. The Settler Constraints option lets you write in the number of settlers you want to start with. You can go as high as 10, but no more. If you choose to start with so many villagers, make sure to add a lot of starting supplies, weapons, healing items and drinks. Also, get high starting and learning skills for all jobs spread across different settlers by using the Randomize option, because you will have a low chance to gain new villagers with so many already in the game. If you have found this video helpful, please consider helping me out by liking this video, commenting about any other issues you would like me to make a video on, and subscribing to see it when I post it. The last way to add new settlers during an active game is a bit more complicated. If you want to max out your villager count and don't want to wait or start over, this is what you can do with the console mode 1.0. To learn how to download, install and use it, consult my previous video, which is linked up here and in the description. Once you have it set up and load up your old game or start a new save, you can add new villagers by going here, clicking on the bug icon, and from the action submenu workers, click on the spawn worker. Back in the game, you just click anywhere on the ground and a brand new villager is spawned. Once you look over his stats, you might decide you do not like him. In that case, go back to the console options and use the remove worker action. This basically kills the worker, so you might want to do this in the corner of the map, because your villagers will now get the Seen a Dead Body negative mood modifier. To spawn 10 new villagers, use the appropriate action from the console. Do keep in mind all of them eat a lot, so spawn in some food as well if you do not have enough. And those would be the three different ways you can gain new settlers in Going Medieval. If you have any questions, ask them in the comments or offer suggestions for new videos. Advice for other players is also always appreciated. Thank you for watching and happy gaming!